Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. With us this week, we have Ned Bellavance, who's also a HashiCorp ambassador, and we're going to teach you some cool stuff in getting started with GitHub Actions with Terraform onto Azure. Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. And with us this week, I have a very special guest. Welcome, Ned.
Hi, how are you, April?
Doing well, Ned. So excited to have you on the DevOps Lab because you are also a fellow HashiCorp ambassador.
I am. I see you've got the shirt on today. I chose not to wear that shirt. I went with the flamingos, but I appreciate that you got the ambassador shirt on.
I think the flamingos match the cold weather mood to help brighten up the cold weather that we both are experiencing. So,
indeed.
Definitely welcomed. Cool. Well, Ned, welcome to the show. Could you tell everyone a little bit about yourself?
Sure. Like, as you mentioned, I'm a HashiCorp ambassador. So obviously I love things like Terraform and Vault. I'm also a Microsoft MVP, got my 5-year disc this year, awesome. Which was pretty exciting. And I create a lot of educational technical content, especially on Pluralsight, especially around Terraform and Vault.
Wicked. Well, welcome. So glad to have you on the show. So today we're going to talk about getting started with GitHub Actions and Terraform. So could you go ahead and kick us off?
Absolutely. So my background is I'm an infrastructure ops kind of person. Mm-hmm. And so GitHub was always a little scary to me because that's a developer tool, people. Yeah. And I don't know what to do with it. And so I didn't pay much attention to GitHub Actions because it was a little frightening. But I want to make it not scary for everybody. So if I can just break it down for a second, what is GitHub Actions? It's a workflow engine. That's it. If you're comfortable creating a workflow, then GitHub Actions works for you. And it's not super scary. You're not writing Go code. It's all YAML, which, I mean, we don't always love YAML, but it is pretty accessible. And it just lets you do something when something else happens. If I want to put it in the most basic terms, it's a workflow engine. So that's GitHub Actions in a nutshell.
And they're so easy to get started with. There's so many templates out there and there's so many things that you can automate with them, not just CI/CD, which a lot of people kind of think of them as. They are absolutely that workflow engine. You can automate pretty much everything with the GitHub Action.
Yeah, I bet you could order a pizza or a taco with GitHub Actions if you really, really wanted to. As long as there's an API, I'm sure you could reach out and do it.
Actually, you can order Domino's pizza using a GitHub Action and Terraform, but that's for another day. why don't you show us how we can use GitHub Actions to do some stuff with Terraform and Azure?
Sure. Well, the big idea here is Terraform is a workflow. When you want to deploy Terraform code, there's a pretty standard workflow you'll go through at the command line, which is, first, I want to check my formatting, make sure my formatting's good. And then I want to check my syntax, make sure my syntax is good with Terraform validate. Mm-hmm. And then I want to plan out what I'm going to deploy. So I'm going to run a plan, review what's in that plan. And then I want to apply that plan to something. That's a workflow. And I can automate that entire workflow with GitHub Actions. So that's what I'm doing with my demonstration today. Basically, we are going to deploy an app service using Terraform. And then we're going to make a change to that app service using a GitOps workflow and GitHub Actions. So I know I threw a new term out there, GitOps workflow, and I'll kind of explain that as we go, if that's okay with you.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, let's get started. I'm excited to see the GitHub Actions and the Terraform code we're going to deploy today.
Okay, so I have the repository up on the screen right now. This is available. It's a GitHub repository. So if you wanted to follow along, there's going to be a link below the video so you can go to this repository, fork it, and follow along. There's a remote setup directory, which walks you through setting up all the prereqs for getting this thing working. And then the main directory has the actual Terraform files. And the really important one is the .github workflows directory. This is where we put our GitHub Actions. So I'm going to drop right into there. I got one file in here. It's terraform.yaml. And like I said, YAML is what describes the Terraform, the GitHub Actions. So first we have to tell it, hey, when do you want to fire off this action? What are the events that might happen in GitHub that would fire it off? And I am telling it I want it to fire on a push or a pull request. This is where the whole GitOps concept comes in. Mm-hmm. When I want to make a change to production, I want to do something different. And we're going to do something really simple. We're just going to change the size of our deployment. I want to kind of check on things first. So I'm going to create a separate branch.
Okay.
And then I will commit that branch to this repository. And that's called a push. I'm pushing code up to the repository. So when I do that, I want to fire off a couple events. I want to check my formatting and my syntax. So on push, that's one of the things we're going to do. Mm-hmm. And I just need to set up a few things here. It needs to download the repository to the runner where it's actually running these actions. That's the checkout process. And I want to install Terraform. So that's this whole setup Terraform portion here. And I have to tell it what version I want. So I'm doing 1.0.10. And then I need to initialize Terraform if I'm going to do a validate. So here's the initialization portion mm-hmm. of the action. And then if I am just pushing code, we can stop right there. And if I wanted to, I could add in an action here to validate the code, check the formatting. If I am, the next part of the GitOps workflow would be a pull request. I've checked my formatting, I've checked my validation, mm-hmm. make sure everything looks good. Now I'm going to issue a pull request to merge this branch into the main branch. And when I do that pull request, I want to run a Terraform plan. And so in the if statement here, I'm saying, if the event is a pull request, I want you to run Terraform plan and then add a comment to that pull request outlining what's going to happen based off of the plan output. So that's the next step in here. And that only happens if it's a pull request.
Right. So we have a condition in which we are only going to run that if there's a pull request. So that means it's not going to run every time. The other thing that I think that's really important to highlight here that you've done really well is you've used secrets properly so that you're not displaying your any kind of secrets, tokens, passwords. And for everyone out there, that's really important. But also that you have full traceability. And that's why this is really cool. So with an ops background, you know, a lot of times we make changes or we might push some infrastructure as code out, but we don't have that traceability. So having that traceability that you built in there is awesome. And that will help a lot of people get started with some great practices in place. That's really cool, Ned. Really good to see.
Thank you. Thank you. And the secrets thing is super important. We'll get to that in a moment. I just want to go down to the very last portion of this, which is the Terraform apply. Mm-hmm. This also has an if statement around it. So this needs to happen when I've accepted the pull request and merged it into my main branch. So I've got another if statement here that says, if we're talking about the main branch and this is a push into the main branch, which is basically what happens when you merge a pull request. Mm-hmm. If that happens, then I want you to run Terraform apply with auto approve and apply those changes to the target environment. So that's everything that's in my GitHub Actions. You mentioned secrets, which is also a super important part of this. If we look at the settings for this repository and go down to secrets, I've set up repository secrets here that give the credentials that mm-hmm. GitHub Actions is going to use against Azure, because it needs some credentials to be able to make changes in Azure. As well as a storage account that's going to hold my Terraform state. So that's all sitting in the secrets. It's not exposed in logs. And this is some of the stuff that the remote setup files actually do for you if you were following along with the demo.
Cool. Very cool.
So to go through the actual workflow, I have the repository open in Visual Studio Code, and I am going to create a new branch, and we'll just call it ADO. Why not?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. And then I'm going to go into my main directory, and under variables, I'm going to make a change here. I'm going to change my size from F1. I'm moving off the free tier. I'm scaling up to S1. Ooh. So I will save. I know I'm going big.
Go hard or go home, Ned. Go hard or go home.
And then I'll just make a quick commit, call it S1. We've moved up to S1. And now I'm going to push those changes as a new branch up to the central repository. And if we switch back to here and go to actions, this has kicked off an action because I pushed it. Mm-hmm. And all it's going to do is run through the basic initialization process and stop there. That's not super exciting. if we go back to the code, it's going to tell me, hey, you just had a new push. Why don't we create a pull request for it? So I'll go ahead and do that and create a pull request. And this should fire off yet another GitHub action, which is this one. Excellent. So it's queued. My demo's actually working. And what this is going to do is run through that plan. If we go back to the pull request and we look at the contents of my pull request, it has started to run a check in here. It knows that it's running these actions. So it's going to run through the pull request action. And when that completes, it's going to fill in the details here with what happens within the plan, what it's actually going to change, which should be just upgrading from F1 to S1. So we can open up the details and see how far it's gotten. So it gives you a nice little step-by-step here of all the different steps that it's taking through. And it looks like it finished. So if we go back, there we go. It has successfully checked out. And we can look at the details of the pull request. It should have added a comment to here. Yep, there's our comment that it added. And if we expand show plan, it tells me exactly what it's changing. F1 is going to go to S1. Awesome. That's what we want to see.
That's exactly what we want to say. No surprises there. We know exactly what's going to change. We have traceability and record of it. Fantastic. Right.
If I like the change, I can merge the pull request. If I hate the change, I can push this back to whoever did and say, no, you have to make an update. I don't like this, but I'm happy with it. So we'll go ahead and confirm the merge. And by doing that, it's now going to kick off yet another action, which is actually merging the pull request into main and applying that change to the target environment. So we can go into this and we'll see if it's actually running. It's in progress. So this would take a few minutes, but if we refresh this once it completes, the app service plan will change from F1 to S1, and I will have an upgraded and fully functional site that's going to be so much faster. And if we go to the URL, it should load. There we go. We have successfully deployed and updated our app service to S1.
And I can have a taco.
And you should absolutely have a taco. It's Taco Tuesday for me. So
awesome.
Have a taco, April.
Thank you, Ned. That was awesome. That was a really easy to follow way to get set up with GitHub Actions. They aren't scary, and it's a great way to deploy Terraform onto Azure. Thank you so, so much. You're right. It's Taco Tuesday. Thank you, everyone, for joining in. We're going to put links to the repo in the show notes so you can reference it and you can follow along and replicate everything Ned did today. Easy to replicate, really good practices in there. So thank you, Ned, once again for coming on the DevOps Lab.
Absolutely. It was my pleasure, April. Thank you again.